sit out today's practice. Cantrell Wills' ankles are proving he could return to practice sometime this week. This report is brought to you by your local Hyundai dealer, where at the SmackDown sales event, you can take home a Sonata for $169 a month. Police details, call 877-216-4114. With reports every 20 minutes, I'm Harris Allen, WFAN 2020 Sports. It's 5:43 this early Tuesday, and time again for the STS Tire and Auto Fan Highway Patrol with Susie Cerrone.
And good morning. This report brought to you by Flushing Bank. For checking matters like savings, open a Flushing Bank Best Rate Checking account and earn 1% APY on account balances of $5,000 or more. Go to flushingbank.com for details. Equal housing lender. Alternate side of the street, parking rules in effect today. Roadwork in Brooklyn on the BQE northbound by the Brooklyn Bridge has your left lane blocked. 59th Street Bridge, Queensbound upper level. That right lane is still shut from Friday's truck fire. Hudson River crossings in good shape. Don't forget till about 6. The lower level of the inbound George Washington Bridge, Palisades Approach, easy pass only. Plenty of roadwork in New Jersey and the Parkway northbound 131 to 135. And 145 to 149, that should wrap up by 6. Good shape on the Tappan Zee Bridge. And in Connecticut, single laning on the Merritt North and southbound through Greenwich till 6 a.m. Then weather today, sunny and hot with a high of 86. Currently clear at 64 degrees in Central Park. I'm Susie Searing with the STSTire.com and Highway Patrol.
The Mets open a 9-game homestand tonight with the first of 2 games against the Atlanta Braves. Hi, I'm Howie Rose. Join me along with Josh Lewin for all the play-by-play. Game time is 7:10 with Mets Extra at 6:30. Right after Mike Francesa and Mike Zahn here on your flagship station for Mets Baseball, The Fan, Sports Radio 66 at 101.9 FM and WFAN at WFAN FM New York.
Back to call as we go, Max, and let it down to the next up on the fan.
Hey, what's going on?
Hi, Max, what's going on with you?
Well, I want to chime in about players getting hit by pitches. I've got a different solution for it than no one. I'm tired of it. I see it as a fault. You know, you're throwing up there. Hard ball, so it's harder to get. Here's my solution. Now, there's shields and everything else, so, you know, players can shield it pretty well. But if you're going to go anything through Sunday night, and you're the player just throwing out the pitcher, well, the penalty is, you know, what the better happens as you mean. The next day, during playing practice, for officials who are trying to serve the players, they have the pitching machine, and execution style, which is a bit better pitch, is hard to be good at pitch the other guy.
Suppose it's on purpose with a change, but the machine is going to go, you know, 70 and hit him. No, no. Put him back in the batter's box and let him hit. Let's go to Bill and have him go to Bill, your fan. Take more of the ball in the cup.
Listen, I played a little high grade baseball and I'm 60 years old.
Okay.
I'm a catcher.
Okay.
All right. And you know what? We seem to get the look of the game.
Yeah.
At 60, you know, I'm doing this. And you know what? Baseball is a cerebral game. You know, you gotta think. You gotta know your batters and stuff like that. You know what? Think about if these guys are on defense pitches. You know what? You don't have to hit anybody maliciously. Unintentional, yeah, that happens occasionally. But you know, what happened with these professionals? Like I said, I'm 60 and I go out there every Sunday. Just recently, my team won. We won undefeated. We won our division 52-0. 22 innings. Saturday and Sunday.
God bless you.
Yeah, Monday I could bail it up a pen.
Of course.
But you go on the ball back to the pitcher over 300 times, both pitches. And you know, these professionals, they don't realize how great they have it.
You know what it is, Bill? You're doing it for the love of the game. They're doing it for the love of money. That's why, you know, you take the gamble, you get caught. Mea culpa, I'm sorry. Shed a tear, talk about the children, talk about religion, and then I can have my check, please. Let's go to Johnny and Manalka. Johnny on the fan.
Yeah, how you doing, Tony?
Come on. Thanks, man. What's going on?
Hi. I just want to tell you, I love listening to you on the radio. It's one of my favorites.
Appreciate it.
minutes. When I seen that when they hit A-Rod, and I see a little kid applauding, you know, to me that was disgusting. Because they look up at their father and they're seeing their father applauding, and they're doing the same thing.
And they'll pass that on to their kids. Like I said, what if the worst case scenario, what if A-Rod got knocked out and they got to take him out on a special? Then what? Oh, let's not